Hi students, now we are going to talk about heat transfer in forced convection experiment. Okay, in this experiment we can see a few important components. Okay, so the first component will be blower, which is used to blow the air to make the flow of air. Okay, and the second component will be orifice meter, which is used to find out the difference in pressure. Okay, which has been connected with the manometer. So this is manometer, which is used to measure the height difference, head of water column, and it will be converted into air column while doing calculation. And there will be a heat supply unit, and this is the test section. Okay, so through this section air will be made to flow, and the heat transfer calculation will be made only in this section. Okay, so to avoid heat loss, we have wound a rope with this tube. Okay, and this is the thermocouple, which is used to measure the outlet temperature of air. One thermocouple will be used to measure the inlet temperature of the air. And now to supply the heat, we are going to give heat input to the air. Okay, heat input to the cylinder, so that a heater dimmer will be used to supply the heat. So we can adjust the heat input by giving voltage, by changing the voltage and the amps. Okay, so now we can set the voltage, which has been set around 60 volts or 59 volts. Okay, and also here we are doing calculations for forced convection, so that we have to make the flow of air. So to make the flow of air, we can adjust the blower dimmer to start the blower, and we can make the change the flow rate of air. Okay, so I can say I can adjust the blower dimmer to make the flow of air at a required velocity. Okay, once we have set the all the values, now we have to wait for steady state condition. So we know well how the steady state condition can be achieved. So here the temperature, successive temperatures can be measured equally, means the system has been reached steady state temperature. Here in this experiment, in the test section, so there are five temperatures can be measured inside the surface of the cylinder. So you can see the temperature T1 is used to measure the temperature of air at the inlet, and T7 is used to measure the temperature of air at outlet. Okay, and T2 to T6, this is the test specimen surface temperature along the length of the tube. Okay, so for this length of the tube, there will be a thermocouple from T2 to T6 temperature. So with this thermocouple, we can measure the temperature of surface and air. So when we need to temperature of T1, means we can adjust the knob to T1 position, and we will be getting temperature of air at the inlet. Suppose if you want to measure the temperature T2, we can change the mode to T2 mode. Okay, and now we can measure the temperature of surface at 0.1. okay, now from T2 to T6, we can adjust the we can adjust the position, and T2 to T6. Now if we set T7, we can measure the temperature of air at the outlet. Okay, so this is the way we have to measure the temperatures. Once the system has been attained steady state, now the steady state temperature values will be taken for calculations. Okay, thank you very much.